Hello everyone, I am Dharmendra Sheth from Surat. Today we are going to talk about pronunciation and we'll talk a little in detail. Now when we want to discuss pronunciation, we must have a model in mind. So for this particular video, we have taken RP, the standard British variety of English, as a model. It is not necessary that you stick to only this variety of English, but for all practical purposes, for learners of English and mainly non-native learners of English in India, it will be good to have RP as a model, because we have a lot of material available in RP and many teachers are also trained in the standard British variety of English. So we will stick to RP. And we will try to understand how RP sounds are different from Indian sounds. And we will talk about all the symbols that we normally use in RP. So if you look up in a dictionary, in any authentic dictionary, for example, Oxford, Cambridge, Longman, Collins, Macmillan, you will find the same symbols. There may be some slight variation, but largely they will have the same symbols. So if you understand what the value of each symbol is, then we'll be able to pronounce words even without listening to the pronunciation given in dictionaries. And I'm sure it will help you a lot in improving clarity in your speech. I don't claim that you'll be able to speak like a native speaker of English after this video, but your pronunciation will definitely improve and clarity will improve. So let me begin with the sounds of English. In English, in standard British variety of English, we have 44 sounds. And out of the total 44 sounds, 24 sounds are consonant sounds and 20 sounds are vowel sounds. Out of these 20 vowel sounds, 12 are pure vowel sounds. We can call them monophthongs. And these 8 are diphthongs. They are actually two vowel sounds in one. So what we'll do, we'll discuss each sound and we will practice a few words as well. So the first sound here in consonants is P. Now in Indian languages, we don't have that aspirated variety of English. In English, we have a little touch of H after P. So it is P, pocket, practical, promise. The second is B. Now, if you look at me, how I pronounce the sound, P and B, they both are bilabial sounds. That means both your lips take part in the production of sounds. P and B, baby, boy. The third is T, time. Again, here we have a slight touch of H sound. In Indian languages, we don't have that. We say time. In English, it is time, topic, test, material. Then we have D, day. You must have noticed that here P and B are similar, the way they are pronounced. The mouth position is similar. In the same way, T and D, they are produced in a similar way. The only difference is that the first is a voiceless sound. Your vocal folds, they don't vibrate. And in D, they vibrate. The same is the distinction between P and B. And again, if you go to the next pair, K, copy, captain, compromise. So K is a voiceless sound. And G in the same position, but a voiced sound, gate. So you must have noticed that this first row, P, B, T, D, K, G, they all are plosive sounds. They are P, T and D are aspirated. That means there is a touch of H sound after them, which is not common in Indian languages. Now we go to the second row. This symbol represents the sound CH. In Indian languages, we have a slightly softer version of it, like CH. But in English, we have CH, China, check, match, catch. And the next is the voiced counterpart, J, magic, job, just. Then the next is a friction sound, fricative sound, in which you try to press your lower lip with your upper teeth, just a little. And then you try to produce the sound. So that's the this is the symbol for that sound. Face, 50, fine. Now in the same position, if you add your vocal folds, then you have V, value, move, river. So CH, J, then F, V. Then we have here again a friction sound. When your tip of the tongue is slightly outside your mouth and you create friction between your tip of the tongue and your upper teeth. So you can look at me how I pronounce. The listener can see your tip of the tongue. And there is friction. Thank you. Method. Thought. Theater. Now if you add voicing to it, if your vocal cords vibrate, then you have this, weather, within, without. Then the next row we have a very common sound, a hissing sound, same, six, not a problem for most learners, and its voiced counterpart z, zebra, zero. Then the next sound, sh, shame, shop, machine. Many learners find it difficult to pronounce and they replace this sh with s, and they might say English. It's not English, it's English. It's not, you must understand that in English, same and shame are not the same. The next is the voiced counterpart, J, vision, pleasure, measure. Many non-native learners of English, they cannot pronounce this sound J, so they replace it with Z and they say pleasure. It is not pleasure, it is pleasure, vision. The next is a glottal fricative sound, H, hot, happy, hat, perhaps. So from CH to H, they were all fricative sounds, friction sounds. Now we have three sounds from here, M, N and ng. These are three nasal sounds in English. Not difficult for learners. M, man, many, mango. N, nest, nine. And ng is usually at the end of a word, like sing, ring. So ng at the end is this sound. Then we have L, not a problem, late, little. In fact, if you go deep into phonetics, then you might come to know that this sound is actually represented with the same symbol, but there are two different sounds. When it is at the end of a word, it is spoken in a slightly different way. So the word little the first sound and the last sound, they are slightly different, though they may be written in phonemic transcription similarly. Then we have the sound R. Now this sound is important because of its absence in the standard British variety of English. When it is at the end of the word or when it is followed by a consonant sound, this R is actually not spoken. So you might have words like mark, park, where the letter is A but it is not spoken. In a word like particular, both the letters are, both the A letters are not spoken. But it is spoken when it is followed by a vowel sound. So the words like red, right, ring, there the sound R is spoken. And it is also spoken in combinations, for example, clusters like br, tr, brain, train, gr, ground, green. So in such consonant clusters, it is spoken. Then the next sound is ye, yes, yellow. It's a little difficult for learners because it is represented with a symbol, J-like symbol, but actually the sound is ye, yes. The next sound, the last consonant sound, is w. You can protrude your lips and then circle, create a circle, and then you produce the sound w. Now this is a non-friction sound. Many learners find it difficult to distinguish between this sound and this fricative V very well. So you can see here wet and wet are different words. So this is the set of consonant sounds. Now let's move on to vowel sounds. You can clearly see there are two sections. The first section has 12 sounds. 12 vowel sounds. Now they are called pure vowel sounds. That means they begin and end in the same way. Whereas here we have diphthongs. Diphthongs are two sounds in one, two vowel sounds in one. So let's see them all one by one. And you can try to remember that when we have two dots, like so, when you see a colon after the symbol, they are long sounds. So the first is E, like feed, read, team, feet, leave. And the second is a short sound, I. So you can distinguish between live and leave, fit and feet, sit and seat. In most vowel sounds, it is less important to produce an actual sound, but it is important to maintain the distinction between the two sounds. So here, this E and E. Then the third sound is E. Your mouth is a little wide open, a little wider than the previous two sounds. In E, it was almost closed, E. Then a slight opening of your mouth, E, and then a little more opening of in A, egg, ten, bed. And if you open it a little further, then you will have a sound A, bad. So here you should be able to distinguish between bed and bad. Ten, tan. Then the fifth vowel sound, it's a long and probably the most open sound in English. It is R, mark, star, article. The next sound is O, as in box, hot. Then the next vowel sound is O. It's not very common in Indian English. You may not hear it very often. But in standard British English, if you listen to, for example, presenters on BBC or newsreaders on BBC, you will listen to this sound very often. It is O, water, organize, ornament, more. The more you work, the more you get. The next is U, put, push. Not a problem. The next is a long sound U, rude, improve. Then the next sound is a typical British English sound, a, as in cup, but, must, enough, blood, love. Then this sound, 11th sound, is probably, not probably, actually one of the most widely used sounds in English. Whenever you have an unstressed part of a word, normally it is pronounced with the sound a. A is the most common sound in English. About, ago. It is spoken with the least effort. And why is it most widely used? Because it is used in unstressed positions. And second, most grammar words in fast connected speech, they will be spoken with a. For example, a becomes a, they are coming. Can becomes can, you can go now. Must becomes must, he must be busy. So most grammar words, they have a. And most words containing unstressed syllables, they will have a. For example, the word opponent. So the letter has O, but the sound is a. Similarly, possess. And the 12th sound, the last pure vowel sound, is er. Early, bird, girl. So these are the 12 pure vowel sounds. We'll revise them once. E, 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 A, A, O, O, U, U, A, A, A. Now you can see in diphthongs, two vowels are put together. So there is a glide from one sound to the other. So for example, if you see the first three sounds here, in the first three sounds, we have at the end the sound E. So they are E ending sounds, diphthongs. So here A to E, A, gate, rate, wait. Then from R to E, I, polite, kind, bite. Then O to E, oi, voice, noise, choice. So first three are E ending diphthongs. Then the next three, they are A ending diphthongs. A, like ear, near, fear, cheer. Then A and A, air, care, chair, fair. Then U and A, poor, sure, cure, insurance. You will notice that in these three diphthongs, the spelling will have A, but the sound R is not spoken. If you see here, near, so the letter A is at the end in the spelling, but it is not spoken. In the same way, chair, care, and similarly, cure. The last two diphthongs, they are U ending diphthongs. So A to U, it becomes O, open, golden, spoken, most of the time, so most. And then we have R to U, house, mouse, mouth, sounds of English. So we have seen all the 44 sounds in the English language in the standard British variety of English called RP, received pronunciation. If you have any questions, you can send me your question via email, or you can comment in the comment section of this video. And if you want to watch more videos about the English language, you can subscribe to our channel Fluent Lingua. You can also visit our website www.fluentlingua.com. I am Dharmendra Sheth from Surat. Thank you very much.